Again, welcome students in online classes arranged by our school LFS Madhupuram Basti. First of all, students, open your book, page number 21, 22, on which chapter number 1 is given. Open page number 21, 22. Now, we have grown the crop, rabi crop. We protect it. We put fertilizer and manure in that soil. The crop become ripened. Then what happens? We harvest that crop and store that crop. Now, यहाँ तक हम लोग पढ़ चुके हैं. We store that crop in metallic bin, in jute bags, in silos, in granaries, whatever. Now, after that in your book it is written that crops are of two types. There are two major types of crops grown in our country. First type is rabi crop, which harvesting time is going on. ठीक है, इसका harvesting time चल रहा है. Rabi crop is also known as winter crop. Their harvesting time is this month, which is continuing at present, March, April. Okay. Examples of rabi crop are wheat, mustard, and all those things. Now, second type of crop which is grown in India is what? Kharif crop. It is also known as summer crop. Summer crop. Examples of summer crop are rice, maize, sugar cane, and all these things. Okay, I think all of you well known about these two kinds of crop grown in India. These two are major crops: rabi crop and kharif crop, winter crop and summer crop. Okay, Nancy. Now, as you know, students, day by day population of our country increases. So to fulfill the requirement of that increased population, what things we should do? Since population of our country increases day by day, so to fulfill the requirement, to fulfill the grains, to fulfill the requirement of cereals to that population, there should be increasement in overall production of crop. क्या करना चाहिए हमको? जो daily day by day population increase कर रही है, वो उनके न्यूट्रिशन के लिए, उनके प्रॉपर न्यूट्रिशन के लिए हमको ज़्यादा से ज़्यादा प्रोडक्शन करना चाहिए क्रॉप्स का. ठीक है, सो वी शुड इंक्रीज आवर ओवरऑल क्रॉप प्रोडक्शन एनी हाउ टू फुलफिल द एक्स्ट्रा रिक्वायरमेंट ऑफ एक्स्ट्रा पॉपुलेशन. ओके, इन आवर कंट्री 1960 is known as golden era. Why? Because in that decade, in that 1960 year, the overall production of rabi crop and kharif crop both increases multifold. Overall crop production increases multifold, increasement as seen in overall production of crop. And on that time, in 1960-1970, India become fully depend on ourselves. बात समझ में आ रही है? Grains के मामले में, cereals के मामले में India full independent country हो गया. फुल इंडिपेंडेंट कंट्री. इसको कहीं से भी राइस लेने की जरूरत नहीं थी, किसी भी कंट्री से वीट लेने की जरूरत नहीं थी. इतना ज़्यादा इंडिपेंडेंट कंट्री इंडिया हो गया उस समय. बट व्हाट हैपेंस आफ्टर दैट वंस अगेन पॉपुलेशन राइजेस डे बाय डे and a day come when the production of crops are not sufficient for extra population. So what steps now we should take to increase overall production of crop? Following are the steps we should take for improvement in crop yield. These steps are given on page number 21 on your book. These are various steps which we should take for overall increment in crop production. Number one, use newly researched healthy hybrid seeds for sowing purpose. This is first point. Always use healthy hybrid newly researched seeds for sowing purpose. Now, second step, make the soil fertile, that is, improve the quality of soil for that particular plant which we are going to sow in that soil. So students, make the soil fertile by using manure and fertilizer to the soil, and of course prepare the soil. Now third point, control the pest by using pesticide. Control the pest by using pesticide, it is also very important for overall crop production increasement. And now next is you can write here that control the weeds from summer crop by using various weedicides which are available in market. Clear? Now next is the protection of plants from diseases. As you know students, many diseases, many pathogens also attack on plants, and due to attack of that pest on particular plant, the plant become unhealthy. Unhealthy plant can't give us sufficient yield. Unhealthy plant can't provide us sufficient yield. So protect the crop from various types of diseases. This is also very important step. And last one, better storage facilities. Your storage facilities should be better. As I told you in previous online class that metallic bin, silos, granaries, jute bags, these are various things in which harvested crop, harvested cereals are stored. Clear? So proper storage facilities should be available nearby for storage of our ripened harvested crop. It is also very essential. And many steps, as I told you, we should take before storage, that is, the grains, the cereals should be sun-dried before storage. Acha sun-dried na kare to kya hoga? Kya hoga ji? Gupta, anvesha kya hoga? Agar sun-dried nahi karte hain hum jo hamara cereal hai, pulses hai, jo wheat hai, usko agar hum sun-dried nahi karenge to kya hoga? Moisture is present in between that seeds, in between that grains. तो moisture से क्या होगा? जब moisture रहेगा तो वो seed germinate कर जाएगा, खराब हो जाएगा, फिर आपके मतलब का नहीं रहेगा, पहली बात. दूसरी बात, अगर moisture present है तो किसी भी seed में, किसी भी cereal में अगर moisture present है तो fungus उसमें attack कर देगी, जिससे वो आपका cereal, वो आपका grain खराब हो जाएगा. So students, proper storage facilities should available nearby. These are various steps which can improve our overall crop yield. Okay, now after this, nitrogen cycle is given in our book. About nitrogen cycle we will study next online class, students. This is all for today. Wait for a moment. I'm going to ask you some questions regarding this video. Okay, students, now we will meet again in next online class. Thank you.
Thank you, students.